Hello students, today we are going to start with a new chapter from unit number 1, the COP and the anthem. Let's look at the details about a writer. William Sidney Potter, an American writer, is better known by his pen name O. Henry. Apart from being a writer, he was also a reporter, columnist, and occasional cartoonist. Before starting with the chapter, let's look at the activities, that is icebreakers. The very first activity given over here is, suppose you have gone to a place where the winter season is very severe. Discuss with your partner the ways in which you would protect yourself in the cold climate. The answers given over here is, you all can write your own answers also, children. Ways to protect from cold climate. Number one, use of woolen cloths, use of air conditioner, warm-up exercises, immunity boost medicines, intake of hot drinks, to sit near fire. This was the first activity. The second activity given over your children is, when you see a cop approaching, you feel either relieved or scared. Discuss with your partner the situation when you feel relieved or scared. Two different sections are given over here. Three different situations under the category of relieved feeling and three different situations under the category of scary feeling. The first given answer over here is, you are walking alone in a dark street. You feel relieved. You are following the traffic rules. You feel relieved. You are guiding people for using masks and sanitizers. You are relieved. Situation under you feel scared. Number one, you are riding a bike without a valid driving license. You are involving in antisocial activities. You are not keeping proper social distance to save from COVID-19 or coronavirus. This was your second activity, children. Now the third activity given over here is, discuss some of the motivating things that can change a person's life. Whatever inspiring thing you feel, you all can write, children, over here. The first thing which is written in this activity is listening to an inspiring speech. Reading the success stories of eminent personalities. Attending motivational camps and seminars. Watching inspiring movies and TV serials. Active participation in various social activities. Believing in our own strengths and capacities. Being respectful, honest, and supportive for others. Now, after the ice-breaking activities, let's look at the difficult words, children, given at page number 28. The very first word is strolled. Walked in a leisurely way. Thanksgiving Day. The fourth Thursday of November marked by religious observance and traditional meals. Resident, old and worn out. Now, let's look at the explanation, children. This story, The Cop and the Anthem, is one of the Henry's well-known stories. In this, the main character, that is protagonist, Soapy, is a vagabond. Vagabond is a person who is homeless, children, or tramp, and and a person who has gone astray and resorted to crime, he thinks that life is in imprisonment is better than freedom. Soapy makes different plans to re-enter the prison, as he has no shelter to protect himself from the severe winter chill. Soapy wants to get arrested, as he feels that there is freedom in confinement, that is jail. He feels he will be free if he is in the jail, if he is arrested. Maybe he wants to escape the responsibilities and anxieties in the real life, and he finds jail a comfortable place where he will not have to work for his livelihood. Soapy earnestly desires to be confined to a jail. The writer describes Soapy's unsuccessful attempt to get arrested in a very humorous way. Now, first thing what he does is he plans to enter a luxurious cafe on Broadway Street, even though he was penniless. That is, he did not have a single rupee in his pocket, and he felt confident of getting entry in the cafe because he was shaven and he had put on a nice coat and a bow, which was presented to him by a lady missionary. Soapy planned to order a roasted mallard duck, a bottle of wine, a cup of coffee, a cigar. He would have it all and would not pay for it. Poor Soapy hoped that the cafe management would call the police and get him arrested on non-payment of the bill. But the head waiter noticed his tattered trousers and decadent shoes. He had rightly guessed that Soapy was penniless and denied him the entry. Thus, Soapy's first plan to get arrested failed. Now, the second attempt. The second attempt, at a corner of 6th Avenue, Soapy caught sight of an attractive shop window. He took a stone and dashed it through the glass. The glass broke with a loud bang. People came running to the spot with the policeman in the lead to see what had happened. Soapy stood unafraid with his hands in his pockets and smiled at the police officer. The police officer agitatedly inquired about the man who had done that. Soapy hinted that it was he who had broken the glass. "Don't you think that I might have something to do with it?" he said that way. But the policeman didn't believe Soapy and refused to accept him even as a clue. He knew men who smash windows do not stay there to chat with the police officer. They run away and they take their heels. Right, children? Just then, the policeman saw a man running to catch a car. Thinking that he would be the culprit, the policeman went running after him. Poor Soapy was twice unsuccessful. The third attempt. The third attempt, Soapy now targeted an ordinary restaurant catering to ordinary customers, children. The service and the quality of food was second grade. It was not so very good. Its crockery and atmosphere were thick. Its soap and napery thin. Soapy easily got entry there. He consumed beef steak, flapjacks, donuts and pie, and then he told the waiter that he had no money. He told him to call a cop, that is policeman. But the waiter refused to call a cop. two strong waiters threw poor Soapy on a pavement. It seemed Soapy's dream of imprisonment would never come true. He wondered if he had become immune to arrest. He was in a state of panic. Now, Soapy's fourth attempt to get arrested, children. What he did, just take a look over here. Soapy saw a policeman lounging grandly in front of a glittering theater. He decided to do disorderly conduct, that is misbehavior, with the hope that the policeman would lay hands on him or arrest him. Soapy began to yell. He started shouting at the top of his harsh voice to catch the attention of the police. He danced, howled, raved, and caused a great disturbance. The police simply turned his back to Soapy and remarked to a citizen that he was one of the Yale, that is, university students, celebrating their failure in the exam. If you score 0 marks, you go on celebrating. So, right, children? So that same thing, policeman thought ki he must be a child from a university or a student of university, and he must be celebrating his failure. But the policeman further said that there were instructions to ignore these lads and not take any action against them, as they were noisy but not harmful. Thus, this attempt failed. With each failed attempt, Soapy became more and more restless. He was dying to get arrested. Now, the fifth attempt. In a cigar store, Soapy saw a well-dressed man lighting a cigar at the swinging light. He had set his umbrella by the door on entering. Soapy grabbed the umbrella and walked away with it, with the hope that the umbrella owner would call a cop. When the umbrella owner tried to chase Soapy, he told him to call a policeman. But surprisingly, the man apologized Soapy, that is, he said sorry, because it was not his own umbrella. He had picked it up by mistake in the restaurant. Now, when he saw Soapy walking away with the umbrella unafraid, he thought it would be his umbrella. Poor Soapy. He failed to get arrested for the fifth time. He threw away, hurled the umbrella angrily because he didn't really want it. He grudged against the policeman because they were not arresting him. The Soapy was in a dejected mood. He was mentally disturbed and badly frustrated, as all his attempts to get arrested had failed. In spite of trying his best, luck was not ready to favor him. Now, the music played a wonderful role in the transformation of Soapy's life. Soapy reached a quiet corner and halted near an old church. As I said you, Soapy reached a quiet corner and halted near an old church, where an organist played an anthem with great skill. The sweet music had very positive effect on Soapy's receptive mind. It proved a mood changer for him. The music notes reminded him of his good old days, family, friends, dreams, ambitions, and hopes. He remembered that he was once an innocent guy with no bad thoughts, bad intentions, and bad actions. The introspection and resolution to change over here in his life was. The church and the music had brought a sudden and a wonderful change in Soapy. He was horrified to see his own degradation, unworthy desires, dead hopes, and base motives. Soapy repented badly. He had gone astray too badly. He had fallen into a pit miserably. Soapy now resolved to change his ways. He would no more continue with his antisocial ways. He would lead a prestigious life. He would make a man of himself. Now let's see the irony of fate, children, here. The moment Soapy decided to mend his ways and be somebody in the world, the policeman lays hands on him and arrested him for suspiciously lingering near the church. Soapy was presented before the magistrate the next day and was sentenced 3 months imprisonment. Thus the story ends on an unhappy note, children. Soapy wins the reader's sympathy and we feel grieved to read about his tragic end. Poor Soapy. This was all about the explanation, children. Now difficult words are still remaining over here. Let's check a look. The next given word on page number 29 is ignoble, that is dishonorable, coveted, greatly desired, limbo, border place between heaven and the hell, agitatedly, in a troubled or nervous manner, callous, very hard, pitched, through. Now you have to guess the meaning of nepri and betook. Nepri is linen napkins, that is tablecloth, and betook is take oneself. Now let's check a look at page number 30. Difficult words given over here is, the first word is elusive, difficult to find, catch or achieve. Rendered, made. He caught at the immediate straw of disorderly conduct. Discuss here the in the context. You have to discuss the meaning over here. Twirled, that is turned. Something quickly round and round. Disconsolate, very unhappy. Arcadia, a mountainous district in Peloponnese of southern Greece. In poetic fantasy, it represents a pastoral paradise. Sauntered, walked in a relaxed manner. Sneered, gave a contemptuous or mocking smile, remark or tone. Larceny, left theft of personal property. Premonition, a strong feeling that something is about to happen, especially something unpleasant. Now next page, page number 31, given words are blonde, a person with pale yellow hair. Soapy was angry because you have to find out the answer over here. Take a pencil in your hand and go on writing. He failed again at getting arrested. That was the reason. Okay, he got angry. Harming instinct, how birds find their nest. Homing instincts, that is how birds find their nest. Turmoil, a state of great disturbance. Quaint, attractively, unusual or old-fashioned. Rumbling, here it means spreading or winding irregularly in various directions. Gabbled, constructed with gabbles. The triangular upper part of a wall at the end of the rigged roof. Sabbath, a day of religious observance and abstinence from work kept by Jews and Christians. Convolutions, coils or twists. Immaculate, perfectly clean and tidy. Now, next page. Maya, here, a complicated or unpleasant situation from which it is difficult to free oneself, resurrect, restore to life, faltering, losing strength. Now, this was all about the explanation, children. In the next lecture, we'll solve the brainstorming activities of the same chapter, inshallah. Thank you.